Goedemorgen, hartelijk welkom terug hier bij het tweede live gedeelte van Technology for Automotive 2020. Ik sta hier naast Maurice van Giezen van Cleantron, die u zometeen mee gaat nemen in de wereld van Advanced Systems for Urban Mobility. Ik hoop dat u al een succesvolle meet and match achter rug heeft en genoten heeft van de pitches van onze exposanten. En het volgende half uur staat dus in het teken van Maurice van Cleantron. Fijn dat je er bent, Maurice.
Ja, dankjewel.
Jij gaat het komende half uur ons alles vertellen over Advanced Systems for Urban Mobility.
Ja, in het Engels.
In het Engels, dat is zeker. Dus dan, want er luisteren als goed is ook natuurlijk internationale. There will be also international speakers, international listeners today. Yeah. So that's very good. So we'll continue in English indeed. If you have any questions during the presentation, please use WhatsApp or YouTube chat to ask them. And in the end, in the last 10 to 5 minutes, we will go ahead and go over these questions with you, Maurice, if that's okay.
Okay.
Okay, then I would like to leave the floor to you. Good luck.
Thank you very much. Hello. So, my name is Maurice van Giezen. I'm director of Cleantron. And here you see our beautiful logo. Cleantron is inspired on the word clean and electron. Cleantron is a specialist battery producer. We produce and develop lithium-ion batteries. And as you can see here on this slide, the options that you have basically is that we do produce basic standard modules that you can apply in your vehicle, or we can develop for you dedicated modules. We do produce on the outskirts of Amsterdam, next door to Schiphol Airport. There we have a factory, there we have our engineering department. And the services that we offer are actually in the area of mechanical design, electrical engineering, particularly in the area of battery management systems. Next to that, we also have an innovation program, our own lab, where we do research, R&D, for lithium-ion cells. We are a company that works knowledge-based, so it means that we want to understand it before we make it. And these are having three layers: the battery technology itself, the battery application, and the battery production. For that we do continuous research, primarily in the area of cell characterization, that we develop the data sets, that we know how to measure how cells do feel, and how we can actually steer the cells, so developing algorithms for our battery management systems. On the second layer, the battery application is helping our customers to apply the battery in their vehicle or product or robot. And thirdly, it is the production itself. So we have developed our own production machines, which gives us tremendous flexibility in actually producing on a serial basis your future batteries. The markets that we serve are the industry market. So industry 4.0, where there's a lot of autonomous vehicles, AGVs, horizontal transportation, but also agricultural systems. The second market segment is a strange market segment of light electric vehicles, a great variety of products that all need batteries. And the third one is the automotive sector. And we are a medium-sized company, so we are focusing on prototyping for automotive OEM, so actually designing and building battery packs for prototypes, but also for some niche applications in defense or luxury or motorsport, where still the quality requirement is very high. Next to the traditional OEM, we have the new OEM, the new type of customers that is there on the horizon, and they are actually developing on their cars, which are normally having a completely different concept. So I would like to talk about advanced batteries for urban mobility. And that is inspired on the fact that there is a great demand in all kinds of vehicle types, as you see here, for batteries that are as well good as affordable. Important there, it is that a part of the answer is in the modularity. And that's basically where it's all about for today. If you are a mid-sized OEM and you are producing vehicles, a few hundred or a few thousand, it doesn't mean that you have to work with inferior battery technology or at very high cost. modules are identical. They are repetitive building blocks. And modules are offering you the possibility to create volume. And volume is the key to get lower cost. That is basically the rationale. And volume still can have their own interface. They can be customized. But if you manage to standardize your battery block, your battery module, you are having a great advantage. And that is particularly applicable on the people active in product development, because it is simplifying the process of new product development in a time where there's great complexity, growing product portfolios and reducing product life cycles. And that makes it really important to have a tool at hand that gives you a true solution to cope with the increasing amount of flexibility that the customer is asking. And if we look at it, our experience and also the studies from Gothenburg University, comparable studies make clear that it can contribute to shorter time to market and lower cost. And that is extremely important in this volatile market. Here you see the importance of volume on the cost of a battery. If you are managing to create scale, you see that the costs go down. And you see here, it is basically a theoretical picture, because we have to make some assumptions. It is based on a 2 kWh battery pack. And it is comparing standard modules with high density or ultra high density or high power chemistries with a tailored module, which we could develop for an OEM. And there you see that around 5,000 units a year, 5,000 modules a year, so if you use 10 modules in one vehicle, 500 vehicles, there's a tipping point where it makes absolutely sense to think about a tailored module that is specifically made for you. The options that we offer is a tailored module or a standard module. Tailored modules are always confidential. I cannot show them to you, so to always have also a standard module. And these are the 2021 standard modules in the 48-volt range, a P4P, P4X, and P4XA. They are basically portable, or they are modules that work in a system, and they can be equipped with active cooling, which is important. Makes life a little bit more expensive, but in some cases it's still very, very good. And you see here on this slide as well the norms against which we can develop, and what the norms are, against what norms these packs are certified or can be certified at your request. So if you have a module, that is one thing, but the whole point is building a module is only half of the solution. The second part is the system, the intelligence of the way the modules work together with your vehicle. And Cleantron is pretty much specialized in that. So we have here basically developed three technologies, and the middle one is really very innovative, and which we can or you can choose four modular approaches. If you look at the left, you see the multi-pack configuration. It's basically putting the packs or the modules in parallel. And the second one is high power MPC, high power multi-pack configuration, which gives the opportunity to get rid of the normal barriers of using, for instance, portable batteries. And the third one is the master-slave, which is the more traditional, common way of working in the automotive industry, but that also can still equipped and executed in a modular way. And you see here the different types of vehicle that are, let's say, candidate vehicles for these kind of different technologies, and I will elaborate a little bit on them. If we look at system one, a multi-pack configuration, it is basically all about putting modules together. You can put them up to 16 in a row. So you can go from, if you use a 2 kWh module, you can go from 2 to 36 kWh, which is basically car capacity. And all the modules, they communicate into Modeler via Canvas. And there are no fixed module positions, which gives a great benefit that if you want to exchange modules, they can work at any moment, at any time, in any position. And you can do it in two ways. You can have the modules being drained, giving power together in a parallel discharge, and you do that if you want, let's say, most power. And you use then modularity because of the scalability. So this little iPhone truck at Munich is basically can be equipped with 6, 8, or 10 modules, dependent on their customer request. So that can be decided at the assembly line of the truck. And the other one is sequential discharging, is that you empty one bare module and then the next one. And that is interesting for portable systems where you do what is called battery swapping. And sequential discharging is particularly of interest for vehicles like cargo scooters or electric scooters. The advantages of this is that there is a functional safety issue, which we also in the Netherlands have experienced with electric vehicles, which is a bit of a gray zone. And modularity will not solve all the problems, but it gives one big advantage, is there is redundancy. If one module for some reason is stopping, the vehicle will never stop, but will remain driving on the remaining modules, which gives a great resilience in the performance of the vehicle. Of course, then you have the flexibility, so the OEM has scalability at his assembly line on how big the battery should be. And it gives also high uptimes in case of repairs, that you can only move out one module instead of taking out a complete battery pack. And this plug-and-play replacement makes that the uptime of the car is much higher. From a safety point of view, modularity is a very good thing, because it is in a way compartmentation in terms of that stops down fire propagation. And every module on its own has the full electronic protection. Now, if you look at the batteries that you can choose, you see in our graph that if you want more capacity standard-wise, you have less current that you can get from the pack. And if you want more current for acceleration or speed, by definition, you get less capacity. And that is particularly a problem for urban mobility, because urban mobility wants a certain amount of range, wants many cases portability, so that you're not so dependent upon infrastructure. You can take out the battery inside to charge it if you have, a scooter or a transport bike. But you still want to have the power for acceleration, uphill, but also for speed. Now, that is an old problem, an old dilemma that we solved with the second one, is the high power MPC, for which we have released a press release a few weeks ago. And this gives the advantage of basically battery swapping possibilities and high power and high speed. So it could be an electric scooter that can drive 100 kilometers an hour. You can drive on the ring of the city, and you can have sufficient capacity. And it is possible because of the fact that it is a dual battery system. It is a system that works with two types of batteries. It is working with a fixed battery in the vehicle and a portable modules. So the portable modules are charging the fixed battery. And the portable modules are having a high capacity chemistry. And they are small. We have a project where the portable modules are about the size of an A4 paper format and 8 centimeters thick only, so they fit even in your bag. You can bring it inside and it has a lot of capacity that is drained into the fixed battery. And the fixed battery deals with the dynamics. And this can be applied on motorcycles or heavier electric scooters. Small cars, you see here the example from the Centiventi in the middle, the Fiat car, which has a fixed battery and a portable battery underneath the front seat. But also it's applicable, for instance, for the marine market, where you have, for instance, a speedboat for higher speeds. The fixed battery is in the boat And the portable battery, high capacity, can be taken out of the boat and charges the fixed battery. How is it working? You need electronics for that. So it's not by definition the cheapest solution. It only makes sense. It is really fulfilling your demand. If you look at it on a vehicle scale, small vehicle, you see here the different areas. You see the battery modules. The battery modules, the portable battery modules, are draining their energy to the fixed pack through a DC-DC converter. And the DC-DC converter is then feeding the at fixed pack. And the fixed pack, through the motor controller, is driving the motor. Now, I have a very complicated animation here, and I'll show it to you, and I'll try to explain it to you, but if you look at it, I'm pretty sure you want to see it again, because there is a lot happening at several places. So if you want to see it again, please send us a mail at info@clintron.nl, and then we can talk you through. Klok is uitgegaan. Okay, so you here see our demonstration vehicle. You see the portable batteries underneath the seat. They are small, they are compact. This is just an example. Yeah? So it can be any four, it could be a scooter, it could be a motorcycle. It is in this case a small electric delivery vehicle. The portable pack, the DC-DC converter, the fixed high power battery, the controller, the motor, and that is the system. And in the dash, you can see what the state of charge is of the portable batteries and the fixed battery. And if the power is on, you see that the portable batteries will start draining their energy into the fixed battery. And that is, even if the car is parked, it can do that. It's ideal also for cars that are using solar power being parked and it can be charged. If you do full acceleration, the power is coming from the fixed battery. In the meantime, the portable batteries are just, in a relaxed way, giving their energy to the fixed pack, and the fixed pack is giving the high energy to the motor. When it is braking, vice versa, and when it is stationary again, the portable pack is draining into the fixed pack. Again, full acceleration, the power is coming from the fixed pack. And you see when the portable pack is getting empty, on the left side, the portable number one, you see that there will be a hot swap, as is it called, during driving. There's intelligence and technology to switch from one portable pack to the other without any disruption. Next time you're somewhere parked, you can exchange your portable pack and continue doing this. And now we are draining from the second pack, feeding the fixed pack, and this is how it goes. We have a Germany project where this is driving. It is still in its early days. It is particularly for interesting for electric motorcycles, small electric vehicles, urbanized environments where there is a shortage of capacity in infrastructure because you can charge your car with portable batteries. The high power MPC system can be executed in different ways, dependent on the characteristics of the vehicle. You see here three examples. You can use, let's say, a very small fixed pack with an LTO chemistry, which is a chemistry that is capable of giving very high power, but has a very low capacity, so you need a little bit more portable modules in option A. Option B, you see, okay, I can choose for a more economical chemistry, which is, let's say, somewhat bigger, but I need less portable modules, or you can even execute this on a high voltage level where the 48 volt modules together in series will feeding the high voltage fixed battery pack. So there's great opportunity in this to create a new generation of urban mobility. with this battery technology. The last one is the master-slave, which is the more traditional one. And this is the traditional way electric cars are currently being built. But the beauty is that we can actually develop that system for a mid-sized OEM. And we can produce the modules. And this is particularly of interest for light commercial vehicles and trucks, the area we are active in. But also non-road vehicles. You see the yellow vehicle on the low end. This looks different, but still you see here that our standard pack can work in this. The P4X high voltage with active cooling. And on the modular level, the module will have the sensing of voltage, temperature and cell balancing in the module. And it is having a glyco heating cooling option. And it works together with a master BMS. The master BMS is looking after the slave BMS being on the module. And the master BMS is looking after the state of charge, state of health calculations, and the vehicle communication. And we have the safety box, which is doing the eye sensing and has all kinds of safety measures. And this together is what we produce in our high voltage workshop. At the moment for the automotive industry or for prototypes and for niche vehicles. So if I'm coming back on the question, how can I make my battery electric vehicle good and affordable and fit for purpose? Affordable is you need absolutely volume. And modularity is the key to create that volume and to use a similar set of battery modules in your different vehicles. It's important that there is roughly, it can be higher, it can be lower, but around 5,000 packs per year, there's a tipping point where you can see, and this is the tipping point, where the tailored module is basically getting underneath the standard module. And that has always to do with the fact that if we develop a tailored module, the costs need to be depreciated over these the relatively limited amount, and therefore the tailored module will be more expensive compared to a standard module. But if you go above the 5,000 units, it makes absolutely sense to do a tailored module because it will be exactly fit for purpose, so it will go underneath the standard modules because it is better fit for purpose for your particular application. Independent if we talk high-density chemistries or ultra-high-density chemistries or high-power chemistries. So if you have a product family, and that can be any type of vehicle, small and big, modularity can contribute to a shorter time to market. It can contribute to a cost saving in development, and it can contribute to shorter lead times. And this is at the moment when the market, as we speak, is growing very fast, a very, very powerful tool for OEM for vehicles to be part of this race. And the module you use to get the economies of scale, and it gives you also a scalability on the vehicle level. And you can think about the customized and tailored module, as I just explained. On a system level, using modules gives you the advantage of scalability. And there are many, many vehicles, I can tell you, that are having a way too big battery and are way too expensive because of this reason. And how nice would it be if you, at your assembly line, can say vehicle number A has 8 kilowatt hours, a vehicle number B has 12 kilowatt hours, a vehicle number C has 20 kilowatt hours, then you are sure that your customer never has excess battery capacity and is paying a far too high price and you are having way too high costs. And this all without compromising on quality. That is the key. So I would like to thank you for your attention. If you have any further questions, we will be happy to deal with them. Questions about batteries, lithium-ion batteries, the chemistries, the modelers, modeler designs that you can consider, or the systems in which you would like to have the modules work. And it can also be about the driveline. Cleantron is working closely together with the controller suppliers as Curtis and Cevcon, and charger suppliers as DeltaQ. So I hope this was all be of interest.
Yes, thank you very much. That was a very nice presentation. Thank you very much. Indeed, there has been questions have been asked by Mr. Max Turner. He asked you about the ups and downs of regenerative braking. Can you explain a little bit on that?
Yes, well, regenerative braking is awful. We, as battery supplier, we don't like regenerative braking because it's dirty energy. It confuses the battery, it gives peaks, it can, upset the battery, but it obviously gives energy back. So if you do regenerative braking, particularly the dual battery, high power dual battery system as explained, we have the fixed battery in between that can cope with these dynamics. So it will not compromise the high capacity, the expensive high capacity chemistries of the portable packs. So regenerative braking, if you do it, know what you're doing and make sure that you also have a remedy in place below 0 degrees Celsius. Because if you're in the winter, the car is completely cold and you start braking, you're upside the mountain and you want to go down with your electric vehicle. And the battery cannot absorb energy below zero in the first meters. And that is also something that is a safety issue. But it can all be managed.
It can be managed. And you have an answer to these questions when it comes to
Electrical measures, thermal measures.
Okay, that's good to hear, Mr. Turner. I hope that your question has been answered by this. And otherwise, of course, you are more than happy, I think, Maurice, to go a little bit more into detail offline. So he can always reach you via cleantron.nl or your contact details. Which will be shared with the audience later. I don't know. I'm looking at the production. Is there any other questions coming in at the moment? No, at the moment, not other questions. Then I have a question. You were indeed talking about volume, and that's then, of course, the way to reach.
Lower cost, of course.
And you are then also the partner to assist companies with that volume. You can handle that, and you can assist them in how to go even to higher volumes by looking at new ways of implementing them.
Yeah, well, the beauty of a standard module is that you enjoy your colleague customer because you both create the volume. Mm-hmm. So if you manage to share modules, for instance, with, for instance, customers active in a different market sector.
Okay, yeah.
And we will be happy to produce those volumes. We are in direct communication with cell suppliers, where a big chunk of the cost reduction needs to be realized.
That's an important thing, right? That connection, because that can be a bottleneck, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, and that's why the planning is very important. Yeah. So it is always very key to know what volume you will need in the future. Mm-hmm. And that's also an advantage if you use with a standard battery, because the chance that we will run out on the supply of standard packs is way lower because we produce them on a larger scale.
Obviously. And then, because you also mentioned, of course, a reduction in cost and lead time, 20 and 30% respectively,
those also
come from that fact.
Yeah, that is compared to an OEM that says, I go to a battery supplier and he has to create a complete new battery for vehicle A and another battery for vehicle B. Compared to that situation, modularization creates benefits.
Okay, so I think that is then indeed, so that makes it obvious, I think, the choices that are presented to the market. If there's not anything else coming on the via our channels, then I this for everybody who wants to ask questions, as mentioned, they can reach you via the Cleantron or by looking at the contact details on our website. That is it for now. Maurice, you still have some work to do today because I think there are still people who want to get in touch with you via our Meet and Match tool.
Yes,
so you will be ready for that in a couple of minutes, I hope. A busy day for you today. For everybody who is now indeed wondering how to go forwards after this, there will be pitches and a Meet and Match, amongst others with Maurice. And you can go there by going to your agenda, your personal agenda of today, where you can click on Go to Meeting, the meeting that you have scheduled. So either if it's a pitch that you registered for, or if it's a meeting that you have scheduled with your with some another automotive professional, one of our sponsors, you can go there via my agenda in the B2 Match tool. I hope that everything is clear on that. We've heard that there might be some technical issues. It's very important that you're not behind a VPN a connection because that can disturb the connection with our B2 Match tool. So it's important not to be behind a VPN so that all the accessibility is clear. Maurice, thank you very much for your time today.
Wow, my pleasure.
I hope to we see each other in the future to actually so that you can go on and can give us an update about how indeed Cleantron is now has reached what you want to achieve, and then we can go further with that. And for now, enjoy the rest of Technology for Automotive Online. Thank you very much.
Thank you.